So you've probably heard of mom brain. People use this term to describe when things slip mom's minds. Turns out this is likely just the result of sleep deprivation and exhaustion. But what is actually happening inside a mother's brain? Hi, Mom. Hello, sons and daughters. Lisette here for D News. Many mothers report that having a child is one of the most meaningful events they've ever experienced. It's life-changing. And from a science perspective, they're right, even when it comes to the structure of their brains. Mothers experience neurological changes that start in pregnancy and continue throughout early motherhood. In a study published in the journal Behavioral Neuroscience, researchers looked at moms' brains at 2 to 4 weeks after giving birth, and then again around 3 months later. Using MRI technology, they found that mothers had increased gray matter in certain areas, the parietal lobes, prefrontal cortex, and others. Yes, their brains literally grew. What's more, some of the growth happened in areas like the amygdala and hypothalamus, which are associated with emotional regulation, survival instincts, and hormone production. The changes here seem to be linked to mothers having a positive view of their babies and an increase in positive feelings toward them. It's what helps moms get up 5 or 6 times at night to a screaming baby without losing any love for them. In one study, researchers at the University of Toronto, Mississauga, analyzed the brain activity of 22 mothers to see if there was anything special going on in their amygdala when mothers looked at their babies versus the babies of strangers. What you'd expect is that mothers would respond more strongly to their own babies, and some women did. These women reported higher feelings of satisfaction with motherhood, a more positive mood, and generally good experiences with being a mother. Conversely, when the amygdala did not become more sensitive during motherhood, it ended up affecting the bond between mother and child negatively. The women who had reduced amygdala responses to photos of their own babies reported poor quality of maternal experience, including increased levels of stress and anxiety. Essentially, these mothers felt they were having a hard time. We know from other studies how important activating these brain regions can be in buffering against negative emotions or feelings in new mothers. In fact, postpartum depression is associated with the binding sensitivity of receptors in the brain that affect the amygdala and other structures involved in the dopamine reward system. This is the same system that is activated when we fall in love with our high school sweetheart. In fact, studies have shown that the same neurological processes are involved in falling in love romantically as with falling in love with our baby. One hormone involved in this process is oxytocin, commonly dubbed the love hormone for its role in bonding and affection. Your body releases it when you hug someone or cuddle. It's when you get that feeling and everything's okay. But it is also released when women are giving birth. It's associated with breastfeeding and it facilitates bonding with a newborn. The hormone spikes during pregnancy, and regions with high density of receptors for oxytocin, like the amygdala, are specifically activated in mothers' brains when responding to babies' faces and scents. In a study published in the journal Frontiers in Psychology, researchers gave women baby pajamas that were worn by 2-day-old newborns. In one group were mothers who had just given birth, and in the other, women who had never had children. When the women were asked to sniff the PJs, all women could smell the baby scent to the same degree. But what was happening in their brains was different. Mothers had more intense brain activity in the dopamine reward system than women who had never had children. The system is involved in reward learning, and it's the same that makes us crave certain foods or become addicted to drugs. It motivates us to act in ways that get us closer to the reward. In mothers' cases, a baby. So yes, mothers can pretty much be addicted to babies. It's why moms can't stop with the kisses, even when you're 22. So how about you show your mom some love in return with something special from K Jewelers? Because every kiss begins with K. Look at the spelling, it's right there. K Jewelers is one of our sponsors at Discovery Digital. They help keep the lights on and the episodes coming. So if you want to score bonus points with mom, go ahead and check out K's line of jewelry. Moms are incredibly attentive to babies' calls of distress, but can they tell what their babies really want? Crystal has a scoop here.
Deer mothers that live in the wilds of the Canadian prairie quickly move towards recordings of infant deer distress sounds, but they also respond to the distress calls of animals they've never encountered before, like infant fur seals, dogs, cats, and even humans.
Do you have a specific childhood memory about your mother or caregiver that makes you smile? Let us know in the comments below, and remember to subscribe to D News. Thanks for watching, guys.